to this particular session here. Okay, now this particular online training session, as you can see on the screen right now, is going to run today and tomorrow. Okay, and we are going to run it from 8 p.m. to 10 p.m. That's for 2 hours Indian standard time. Okay, so it is only for 2 hours, and the total training session would be for 4 hours. Okay, now this training session is coming to you from me, that's Franklin John, and I would be conducting this particular session to you. Okay, now few of the participants out here already know about me, but for the others, okay, well, again, let me repeat, my name is Franklin John, as you can see on the screen, and I am a CCIE in security, and just lately I am a CCSI as well, that's a official Cisco trainer. So the purpose of this particular demo session that I've kept is primarily to make people aware of how sessions are conducted online. And personally, it's like, you know, my opinion is like people in India as such especially are not so aware of online trainings, and just to make it a bit more popular, I thought of this particular idea, and hence we are here to join this particular training session. Okay, now there are few of the participants who are yet to join, so for them what I'm going to do is I'm going to share this particular meeting in the form of video recordings, and for everyone who is going to be a participant for this training session, I'm going to share the training videos. Okay, so you can always refer to it back later, so as such it shouldn't be a problem. So let me just quickly start off. Okay, so the course that we are going to do out here, now I'm not going to cover the entire training program, I'm just going to do a small portion of it, because as you know the training program is actually of 40 hours, but we are only going to cover a period of 4 hours out of it, and the training actually is a part of interconnecting Cisco networking devices accelerated. Okay, so that's what I mentioned by X. X out here means accelerated. Okay, now what do I mean by this accelerated? Now for those of you who have been closely following Cisco training, okay, you would already know CCNA certification, when I talk about it, it has two parts to it. Okay, it has basically ICND 1, okay, and ICND 2. Okay, these are the two papers that make up CCNA, but then Cisco has always had a separate composite exam. Okay, composite exam means a combined exam which covered the topics out of ICND 1 as well as ICND 2 together, and provided you with one exam, that was 640802 earlier. Okay, this was the older exam. Okay, but the latest exam number starting with CCNAX version 2 is 200-120, and that's what this demo session is focusing upon. Okay, so in this demo session, what I'm basically going to do is tell you more about this particular exam, that is 200-120. Okay, I'll tell you what are the topics that have been included and what are the new topics that have been included in the new version of CCNA. Along with that, I'm also going to give you an introduction towards my company. Okay, that is Frankwell Consultancy Services. Okay, I'm going to give you an introduction towards my contact details, so that you would be able to take or access my services in the future. Okay, I'd also be giving you an introduction towards the topics that we are going to cover as part of the CCNX, and I'll also be giving you info about the future training program that I am planned to do over a period of the months that are coming through. Okay, at any point of time, if you have any questions, please make sure to put in your questions in the chat window, and I'll happily return those questions, and I'll discuss those questions directly so that everyone out here who is participating in the meeting can hear it. Okay, so as such, do not hesitate to put up your questions at any point of time, and I'll immediately respond to that in the chat window. Okay, if you are comfortable using your microphone, you can also ask your questions over the microphone, and I can also respond back. Okay, now going ahead. Okay, so this is what I'm going to do first. I'm going to give you an introduction towards the CCNX version 2. Okay, so that's what I'm going to do first of all. Okay. Now, as far as this course is concerned, CCNA Accelerated version 2. Okay, these are the primary skills and knowledge that is needed for attending this training program. Okay. Now I'm sure all the participants of this particular session are familiar with the basic computer operations. Now what I mean by basic computer operations is, you know, turning on, turning off a computer, you know, people know about what is a computer. Now when I say a computer, it can be a laptop or a desktop. So people should be aware of what is a PC. Okay, so basic PC operations is what I mean by basic computer operations. So that's what I need from the people who are going to attend this training program. Okay, people should also be familiar with the computer operating system. Now it is not necessary that all of you should be aware of Microsoft Windows. Okay, even if you are aware with Linux or the Linux operating system, as few of you call it, it's more than enough for us to attend the training program. Okay, so you should have a basic understanding of how to navigate through the computer operating system. Okay, that is, what is the start menu, what are the applications that are running. A basic knowledge about all of that is what is needed to do this particular training. Okay, and on top of it, it would be a plus if you already know about internet, if you already know about how to work on the internet, and which I'm sure that nowadays most of you know about how to work on the internet. If not anything about internet, at least you know how to chat, how to access Facebook, right? Because for certain people, internet means Facebook. You know, that's the concept nowadays people carry. So that's the kind of information, or that's the kind of skills and knowledge that people need to attend this particular training program. Okay. Now let me ask you a question at this point. Are you guys able to hear me very clearly, or is there a lag or any issues that you're facing understanding me? Please respond in the chat.
No, we can hear.
Okay. 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 So that's the basic knowledge that you need from you know, the participant for attending this particular training program. Okay, but the whole idea, what I need from you guys is, like, you know, when since you're attending this 2 days session, okay, what I would expect from all of you is to have a good feeling and to have a good understanding of what's happening during the session, so that, you know, you can always understand how the actual training session of CCNAX would be. Okay, so this is like a trailer towards the actual training program that we are going to conduct online. Okay, I'll be giving you details about when we plan to have those future sessions, but I'll also be giving you details about all the other training programs. But please try to take as much advantage as possible of this particular demo session. Okay. Now the goal and objectives of the CCNAX or the CCNA Accelerated Training Program is to develop the knowledge and skills necessary to install, configure, operate, and troubleshoot small and medium-sized networks. So we'll be starting off our training program right from understanding what is a network, okay, and hence we'll also be understanding about what is a small network and a medium-sized network. Okay, so we'll be understanding all these terms. So it's not necessary that you already need to know what is a computer network and so on. Okay, so we'll be starting right from the basics, because as you could see from the previous slide, you know, I'm not asking you to have a prerequisite with regards to understanding networks, IP addressing, and all that. You just need to have a basic understanding of computers, and I'm going to teach you things right from the basic, right from the scratch. Okay, so you'll also need to, or you'll also understand about how to connect to a WAN, that is a wide area network. What is a WAN? Again, that is something that you're going to learn as we go along in this particular course. Okay, and most importantly, there are also certain topics which deal with implementing network security. Okay, so at the end of this particular training program, the participant, okay, would have a good understanding of installing, configuring, operating, and troubleshooting small and medium sized networks. Okay, so that's the whole objective of the training program. Okay, now like I mentioned before, okay, the training program, okay, not the demo session, okay, let me repeat that again. The training program, when I mean, what I mean by that is, I am referring to the CCNAX version 2. Okay, that training program, when I talk about it, it allows you to earn the CCNA routing and switching exam. Okay, so throughout the course, you will find me giving you tips and tricks of how to attempt this particular exam. Okay, of course, I am not going to help you attending the exam. what I'll only help you do is get to know about what are the questions that might come in the exam. I'll give you the material, I'll give you the course contents and all this kind of stuff, okay. So I'll basically help you prepare for the exam, but as far as giving the exam is concerned, you'll have to approach the VUE testing center, that is Pearson VUE testing center in your respective locality, and you need to go in there, register for the online exam depending on the schedule that you want to give, and accordingly you can register for the exam and go for the exam. Okay. Now when I talk about this exam, it's an online exam wherein you'll have a few questions. Okay, now when I say few, around 50 to 60 questions, and you'll have 90 minutes to cover all those 50 to 60 questions. Now the questions, when I talk about it, they are not objective. Okay, it is a combination of objective questions. Now what I mean by objective questions is you'll have a question and either multiple choice or it can be a single choice. Okay, wherein what I mean by that is certain questions may have multiple answers, and but then there can be other questions which may have just one answer. Okay, so that is what I mean by multiple choice or single choice questions. You would also have simulation. Now in this CCNX course, you'll also be learning about how to configure Cisco routers, Cisco switches. You know, so you'll be learning about command line configurations. You'll be learning about how to configure it through the GUI, that's the graphical user interface, you know, through the web browser and all that. So there would be simulation questions wherein you'd be actually asked to configure a router or a switch, and then accordingly you'd have to meet certain objectives. So I'll give you more details about all of this when we go through the course. But then the point is, you know, along with the objective questions, you'll also have some simulation. And remember, whenever I talk about this exam, a more amount of weightage goes to the lab exam or goes to the simulation question. Okay, so if you miss out on the simulation question, you lose considerable points. In fact, you can lose such an extent that you may even fail the exam. Okay, so simulation questions carry a huge amount of weightage. Okay, now the entire exam is of 1000 points, and out of the 1000 points, I think you are supposed to score somewhere around 850 points to clear the exam. Now ideally I would not recommend you guys to only target for the 850. I would request all of you to target for the 1000 points, okay, because when you target for the 1000 points, you will automatically be able to score a higher percentage, okay, because if you ultimately only aim for the 850, you might end up even getting less than that. Okay, so it's always a good idea to target 1000. So that you are close enough to clear the exam. Okay, so it's always a good idea to aim for the full marks. Okay. Now, the topics that you're going to cover in this course typically are operation of IP data networks. Okay, wherein we'll be talking about what is this IP, that is Internet Protocol. We'll understand more about networks. We'll then go on to understanding switches and the switching technology. Okay, so we'll be talking about more about these Cisco switches and how to operate on that. There will be a separate section talking about IP addressing, that is IP version 4 and IP version 6. Nowadays on the internet it's mostly IP addressing version 4. Okay, but in the future we would also find IP addressing version 6. So we'll be learning about both of these. Okay, but IP version 6, we'll not be getting into more details, but we'll have an introduction towards IP version 6 as well in the course. We'll also be talking about routers and routing technologies. We'll then be talking about the various networking services like DHCP, SNMP. Okay, now what is this DHCP and SNMP? If you're not aware of it, we'll be definitely learning about this in more details as we go along in this course. Okay. We'll then be talking about network device security, how to provide security on a Cisco router and a Cisco switch. We'll also be emphasizing and focusing more on the network troubleshooting, and ultimately we'll be talking about the WAN technology. Okay. Now of course these are the 8 headings under which all the topics of the CCNAX are divided into. Now in the future slides, what I'm going to talk about is the individual topics under each of these individual heads. Okay, so let's go ahead and go through them. So starting with operation of IP data networks, we'll start off with understanding what is a network, and then we'll take a look at the operation of IP data networks. Okay, so we'll recognize the purpose and functions of various networking devices like routers, switches, bridges and hubs. We'll understand what are these devices, how they operate and so on. So that will be the first topic that we're going to deal with. We'll then talk about the various components that are used for different purposes. You know, where are we going to use what different device? Okay, so we are going to understand where each and every of this networking device fits into. Okay, which part of the network are we going to fit an individual device? That's what we're going to understand. We'll also be talking about the common applications. We'll then talk about the OSI model. Okay, now whenever we talk about networking basics, okay, networking basics typically involves OSI model and TCP/IP model. What are these? We'll talk about this more in the course, as well as we'll be talking about this in our demo session as well. Okay, we'll also be understanding how traffic or information flows between two computers on a network. Okay, like as we go along in this particular session, you'll understand that when I refer to computers, I'll also be referring to them as hosts. Okay, so we'll understand how data or traffic flows between computers. Okay, so that's what another thing that we'll look at. We'll also be identifying appropriate media or cables or ports or connectors that may be used for connecting network devices to other devices and computers in a local area network. Okay, so if I want to form a network, what are the components that I would need, and accordingly we'll be talking more about them as we go along. Okay, so that's the first heading. The second heading that we are going to move on into would be LAN switching. Okay, wherein we'll be focusing more on the switches as a device. Okay, Cisco switches. So here we'll understand the technology and the media access control method. Okay, for Ethernet networks, we'll understand this term known as Ethernet. We'll also be understanding concepts related to switching like collision domain, broadcast domains, the various types of switching. We'll also be understanding this technical term about CAN table or MAC address table. Okay, we'll be also understanding how to configure and verify switch configurations, the various commands that can go into Cisco switches. We'll also be learning about various troubleshooting utilities like ping, telnet or SSH. We'll be learning about enhanced switching technologies like RSTP, PVSTP, ether channels. Okay, now do not worry, like we'll be learning more about this in the course. Okay, but these are the topics that we're going to cover. We'll also be understanding about something known as VLANs, that is virtual LANs, how to configure and verify the virtual LANs. We'll also be talking about dynamic trunking protocols, auto negotiations related to that. For those of you who might have attended CCNA training programs, you might have heard about few of these terms. But even if you are not really aware of it, you'll be understanding it more when you learn about CCNA or when you attend the course related to CCNA. Okay, we'll also be learning things related to PVSTP or how to configure and verify PVSTP. Okay, that is spanning tree protocol, per VLAN spanning tree protocol. That's what it is, and we'll be learning about how to configure and verify the operations of per VLAN spanning tree protocol. Okay, that's again a switching term which we'll understand more when we go through the course. As I told you before, over the internet we typically make it of internet protocol version 4 or IP version 4, but in the future IP version 6 is also going to come in. So as far as IP version 6 is concerned, it's a generic introduction. If you want to learn more about IP version 6, it's in the next level of Cisco, that is network professional or NP level. That's where you learn more about IPv6, but out here we are only going to focus more on IP version 4 and an introduction towards IP version 6. So we are going to understand certain terms known as private addresses and public addresses. We'll then talk about the IP version 6 addressing scheme. We'll be learning about terms such as variable length subnet mask, summarization. We'll also understand the requirements related to IP version 6 to be implemented in an IP version 4 network, such as dual stack is one of the things. And we'll be learning certain terms associated with IP version 6 addresses. Okay, now I'll be also sharing this presentation with you guys. So along with the training videos, you'll also have access to this PDF. Okay, so it shouldn't be a problem. At any point of time, if you want to refer back, you'll also have this PDF file with you for later reference. Okay. As far as routing technologies are concerned, okay, that's the list of topics that you have under routing technology. Now, for those of you who have not attended any of the CCNA training programs before, it would be very difficult for me to like really talk about these terms which you see in the slide right now. Okay, but these are the topics that are covered in the CCNA version 2. Okay. As far as IP services are concerned, it will be typically related to DHCP services. Okay, we will be also learning about access lists, something related to NAT, that is network address translation. We will also be talking about NTP, that is network time protocol. We will also be talking about certain high availability measures like VRRP, HSRP, CLBP and all that. We will also be learning about syslog. We will also be learning about SNMP version 2 and version 3. Okay, so all these services we are going to get into details under this course. Okay, we will also be talking about device security, wherein we will be locking down a device so that only restricted users will be able to access a particular device like a router or a switch. We will also be learning about how to put up passwords on the device. We will also be learning about SSH access, that is secure shell access or telnet access. We will also be learning about switchboard security, wherein we will be talking about port security, and then we will be talking about VLAN security and so on. Okay, we will also be talking about putting up access lists on a router as well as on a switch. Okay, so we will be talking about all of these aspects. As far as troubleshooting is concerned, whatever topics we are going to learn in the other heads, we are also going to learn about how to troubleshoot each one of every topic. If there are any issues associated with each and every topic, how do we troubleshoot it and what are the commands related to that. Okay, so that is what this list of topics which you see out here. Under WAN technologies, we are going to understand about metro ethernet, satellite communications, cellular 3G or 4G networks. Okay, so we will be having a general introduction towards cellular 3G networks and 4G networks. 3G is what is more popular in India, but slowly we will be moving on towards 4G as well. So we will be understanding about 4G. MPLS, which is again one of the most popular WAN technology that is used on the internet. T1, E1 technologies, ISDN, DSL, frame relay, cable and VPN. We will be learning about all of these, and we will be talking about configuration of basic serial connection, basic PPP connections, frame relay, and we will be learning a new thing known as PPPoE, that is point to point protocol over ethernet, typically used in broadband connection. Okay, so we will be talking about all these kind of technologies as well. So effectively these are the topics that we have. Now all of these topics will be covered over a period of 40 hours. So that is the reason, like I said in the start of this particular session, we are not going to cover all these topics because this is just a demo session for you guys to understand what this course is all about. And I have given you a breakup of all the topics of how we are going to cover all these topics and how many hours we are going to spend and all of this kind of stuff. Okay. Now as far as the course flow is concerned, the total course would be of 40 hours. Okay. So but then what we are going to do is, since we are going to cover it online, okay, I am going to cover it only for a period of 2 hours daily. So 2 hours daily, we are going to cover it over weekdays, that is Monday through Friday. Okay, and I have plans to start CCNA training, this latest CCNA training from 3rd of June. I will give you more details when we get to the next slide, wherein I will be discussing about schedule. But this CCNA course would be for a period of 40 hours, so which means we are looking at 20 days. Over a period of 20 days, we are going to cover this training session over a period of 40 hours. Okay, that is 20 days. Two hours daily, Monday to Friday, and that is how we are going to do it. Okay, so we are going to cover this session online, and we are going to use WebEx for that, the same tool which we are going to like on which we are running this current training program. Okay, and I think you guys might have had a pretty good experience as of now about this particular software, because it is one of the world renowned training softwares available from Cisco. Okay, now remember, so WebEx is also from Cisco. So as such, we are not using any particular software out from Cisco. Okay, we are using this particular software from Cisco, and we are going to do this particular training. Okay, now the topic, that is building a simple network, I will be covering a portion of it in our demo session, but ideally in the full course we are going to cover this training of building a simple network over a period of 3 hours. Establishing internet connectivity, this topic we are going to cover it over a period of 5 hours. We will be covering managing network device security for a period of 3 hours. Introducing IP version 6, we are going to cover it over a period of 3 hours again. Troubleshooting basic connectivity, here again we are going to cover it over a period of 2 hours. building a medium sized network, we are going to cover it over a period of 2 hours again, okay. Wide area networks, we are going to cover it over a period of 6 hours. The routing protocols like EIGRP and OSPF, EIGRP we are going to spend 5 hours, OSPF again 5 hours, and network device management we are going to cover it in a period of 4 hours, okay. So totally there are 10 topics that we have in this particular course, and totally I am going to spend 38 hours looking at all of these topics, okay. Now what about the remaining 2 hours? The remaining 2 hours is the generic introduction, that is what we are doing today, okay. So most probably we will be starting off the topic of our demo session, that is building a simple network today, or we might start it off tomorrow. But then the point is, like, you know, the first 2 hours may be spent in feedbacks and all those other kind of administrative work, but effectively, you know, we are going to spend around 40 hours covering this particular course. Now it might happen that this course might extend beyond 40 hours, okay, due to unavoidable circumstances, like maybe certain participants are not able to attend a particular training program, or maybe even I am not able to conduct a particular session, or it is not going to happen that way, but then I am like, you know, unforeseen circumstances if I talk about it, due to which if we are not able to conduct the session, it might happen that our course might get a bit delayed or we might extend a few days. But as such, the overall course is for a period of 40 hours. And as far as my reputation goes, I try to cover the training session always within the time period, because I always like to stick within my time schedule. And you'll know, like, you know, typically you'll find that the training program is supposed to finish within 40 hours. Okay, that's how it's going to be. Now, if I talk about Cisco Career Certification, okay, we have an entry level certification, that is CSET. Okay, that is Cisco Certified Entry Level Network Technician, okay, that is what it is. Then we have the associate level, wherein we have CCNA Routing and Switching, that is what is the CCNA demo session all about. Then we have CCNA in the security track, CCNA in the voice track, CCNA wireless, and CCDA, that is the design track of Cisco. Under the routing switching, we then have the professional track, that is CCNP, Cisco Certified Network Professional, and then we have the same level for security, CCNP security, CCNP voice, CCNP service provider, and then we have the CCDP or the CCNP design, okay. We also have the expert level of Cisco, that is the routing and switching CCIE, CCIE security. We have CCIE in voice, CCIE in storage, CCIE in service provider, and also we have CCD, that is the CCIE level certification in design, okay. We also have one more known as architect, but I have not put up CCAR, okay, that is another certification at the architect level, but I have not put that up in this particular slide. But we are typically in this portion here, CCNA routing and switching, okay, that is what I am promoting in this particular demo session here, okay. Now as far as the CCNA course goes, even Cisco provides you with a CCNA prep center, okay. This is part of the learning network from Cisco. So if you visit the Cisco website, you have a Cisco CCNA prep center, wherein you can have access to certain pre study material and pre information related to CCNA, about how to prepare for CCNA, and there are some forums which you can go through and understand how other people are registering, how other people are studying for the CCNA. Similarly, I would also be helping you out with regards to the CCNA preparation if you attend the training program, okay. Now talking about the company, that is Frankwell Consultancy Services, it is through this company that you are able to attend this particular training demo program, okay. Now if I talk about this particular company, okay, this company was established in 2007 and it is a leading technology training and consultation company, okay. So we have been providing training programs, but mostly on site and corporate training programs, which is what we used to provide. We also used to provide training programs into training centers, or we used to conduct training programs in hotels and like, you know, private training facilities and so on, okay. And just lately we have introduced these kind of online training programs, okay, on various technologies which I'll be discussing as we move along, okay. Now the mission of this particular company is to provide cost effective and optimum solutions towards designing, implementing, managing and supporting computer networks and infrastructure, okay. So we believe in providing training programs at a very cheap rate, okay, but at the same point of time we do not like to compromise on quality of training, okay. We would like to maintain the same quality of training but at a cheaper rate, okay. That is what we intend to deliver, okay. Now the training programs which I have started off with as of now is the CCNA, CCNP and CCIE training programs with regards to routing and switching, security and voice, okay. So we are not just limited to the routing and switching track of Cisco, we are also focusing on security and voice, okay. And the Microsoft, the latest Microsoft certifications of MCSC and MCSA related to 2012 server, Exchange Server 2013, Windows 8, okay. So we cater to these, as well as if at all the requirement comes in for the older technologies like Windows Server 2008 or Exchange Server 2010 or Windows 7 or Windows Vista or any of the older training programs from Microsoft, we are even capable of delivering those training programs as well. Apart from Cisco and Microsoft, we also deliver training programs from EC Council, wherein you have ethical hacker, forensic investigation, okay, then you have security analyst, license penetration tester. So these are some of the few training programs that we offer from EC Council. If you have heard of CompTIA, okay, they provide you with basic certification programs like A plus related to computer hardware, Network plus related to computer networking basics, Server plus related to server operating systems and servers, and then you have Security plus related to computer security. So we do offer these kind of training programs as well. And then with regards to process certification, we have started off with ITIL, that is IT infrastructure library, which is typically useful for IT managers or decision makers of an organization, okay. So we also deliver training programs with regards to these, okay. Now we also deliver many more other training programs which are not included in this particular slide, but if at any point of time if you want to know anything about other training programs that we offer, okay, feel free to contact me, okay. I'll be giving you my contact details as we go along, but you can also see my contact details in the slide here. You can see my email address as well as my mobile phone number, okay. If you are not able to see it, just let me know and I'll be providing it to you as we move along again, okay. But if you look at it, these are some of our upcoming schedules of online training programs, okay. So I've only listed my online training programs in this particular slide, okay. So the CCNA training program which I'm going to start off next week, starting 3rd of June, okay. Now all the timings that I have mentioned out here, all the schedules that I mentioned out here are according to Indian standard time, okay. So if you want to know more about the standard times related to your locality or with regards to your time zone, please feel free to write to me and I will be more than happy to respond back to you, okay. So we are starting off with CCNA routing and switching on the 3rd of June. This training program would be again for a period of 20 days, which we will be covering it during weekdays, Monday to Friday, 8 p.m. to 10 p.m. Indian standard time, okay. From EC Council, I am planning to start off with certified ethical hacker, okay. We recently concluded one certified ethical hacker training program, which you might have seen from my newsletters which I sent across to you guys, okay. And I also posted my newsletter on the Facebook page, okay. So if at all you do not have access to that, I will definitely be sending you the newsletter again and you can have a look at it, and you would be able to have access to the testimonials from that previous training program that I conducted. But it was a huge success, that is what I can tell you. But I plan to launch the ethical hacker program on the 10th of June 2013. Again, this training program would be during weekdays, Monday to Friday, but this would be in the mornings at 7:30 a.m. to 9:30 a.m. for 2 hours for a period of 20 days. Okay, and I'll be carrying it out starting 10th of June. Okay, again, Indian standard time. Okay, I do have plans to start off with the firewall module of CCNP security. Okay, only the firewall module. I'm not covering other modules, but if you're interested in that, you can always write to me and I can surely put up a schedule for that. Okay, but as of now I have plans to start off the firewall module during weekends starting 15th of June. Okay, this would be over a period of again like I think 20 days again. Okay, so 20 we are looking at 10 weekends, that is Saturday and Sunday, okay, together. So 10 weekends is what we are looking at here. So again it will be period of 7 a.m. to 9 a.m. that is what we are looking at over weekend. Okay, but if you are not comfortable with the time you can always write to me and I can always upload a different time period for you specially. Okay, I am also planning to launch a route module from CCNP routing and switching, okay, which I have plans to start off 8th of July. Okay, so for the participants who have completed the CCNA, for their convenience I am also planning to launch CCNP route. Okay, so this schedule is in accordance to that, but if at all you want a schedule before that feel free to write to me and I will definitely reply back to you. Okay. Now this is where you can contact me. Okay, these are the various options that are available to you. Okay, feel free to make a note of this information because at any point of time during the session or even after the session, even after we complete with the demo session, if at all you want to contact me, okay, that's the option that we have. The primary option that is available is email. So I have put down my 3 email addresses which I frequently check, and I am always available on these 3 email addresses. But the maximum turnaround time which I'll take for replying to your email addresses would be probably half a day or maybe one day, you know, primarily because I may be involved in a lot of other training programs and consultation project activities. So it may not be always feasible for me to reply to your emails immediately, but if at all you want a reply or if at all you want have certain query, feel free to write to me at franklin@frankwell.co.in, that's my official email address, or you can access me on Gmail. Okay, so which means you can always chat with me on Gmail. I'm also available on Hotmail, that is frank_john@msn.com. So remember the John is J-O-N, not J-O-H-N. Okay, so that's what you need to make a note of. I'm also available on mobile phone, but if I'm in a training session, I prefer not to attend mobile phones. So you can always text me or SMS me on my mobile number. Okay, now this would be typically for my Indian contacts, but even if you are abroad, okay, there are a lot of options by which you can contact me on my mobile. But yes, preferably I would prefer all of you guys to contact me on email or chats. Okay, for chats I have the social networking options like Facebook, that would be one of the things that you can access me on. Okay, you can also get me on Twitter. You can follow me on Twitter at frank_fcs. You can always access me on WhatsApp as well. For those of you guys who do not know about WhatsApp, Viber is again one of the popular applications that is available on Android and iOS application, that is Apple. Okay, so you can reach me at that as well. Okay, so on both of these, WhatsApp as well as Viber, I am available on this particular phone number. Okay, so you can get me on that particular social networking medium as well. Okay, so be sure to make a note of this inquiry, this contact detail of mine. So at any point of time if you want to contact, feel free to contact me on any of these mediums available. Okay, so that was the introduction part as far as the introduction towards the course, introduction towards the company and introduction towards me is concerned. Okay, at this point if you have any questions feel free to come up with those. I will be spending around 5 minutes to answer your questions if at all you have any, and if not then we will proceed with the next part. Okay, so I will give you 5 minutes now to come up with your questions and we can discuss about all of those. Okay, okay, now before you come up with your questions also let me repeat that if you want more details about the schedule that I have floated before about the fees and the pricing and how would you pay for it and the payment information and all that, if you need to know all about that feel free to write me or contact me on any of the details that I gave you, and I'll surely give response to you about how to you can register for and how you can attend these training programs. Okay, so do not hesitate to do that. Yes, so we'll have a short time period of 5 minutes wherein I'll be available to answer any of the questions if you have. Thank you. Okay, so I don't see any questions at this point. Okay, so let's, I think we can continue with the next part of the session today. Okay. So in this particular demo session, I intend to cover a small portion of the actual CCNX training program. Okay, and that's what you see on your screens right now. So the first topic of the CCNX training program is what I'm going to cover here. Okay, remember I'm not going to cover the complete topic, only a part of it, but it's going to give you a good idea of how the training program is going to be. Okay, so the actual training program, just to remind you, is going to start off on the 3rd of June. Okay, 8 p.m. Indian Standard Time, just like the time that we started the demo session today. So I would request all of you to register for the training program before the end of this week. Okay, so that it will be easier for me to manage and arrange for the training program properly. Okay. Now, as far as building a simple network is concerned, okay, that's what we are going to start off with first. Okay, now building a simple network, when I talk about it, what we are going to start off with first is we are going to understand what is a network. We are just going to understand this term network first of all, and then we'll get on into deeper understanding of what the topic is about, or how you can implement a network, or how you can build a small or a medium sized network. Okay, so that's what we're going to talk about out here in this section here. So first part that we are going to deal with under building a simple network is exploring the functions of networking. Okay, so let's try to understand certain terms associated with network and the functions of a network. That's what we're going to talk about first. Okay, so when I talk about a network, okay, what do I mean by a network? Now, of course, when I talk about a network in this context here, we are referring to computer networks. Okay. We are not referring to anything else out here, we are referring to computer networks. Okay, so when I refer to computer networks, a collection or a grouping of computers, okay, so that they can communicate with each other. Okay, a collection of computers or a grouping of computers so that they can communicate with each other. That is what is called as a computer network, or that is what is called as a network. Okay, so when I talk about a computer here, okay, now a computer can be a laptop or it can be a desktop computer, but in today's case or in today's time, okay, just talking about a computer as a laptop or a desktop may not be correct or may not be technically accurate. Okay, you have to include a PC. You have to PC as in a desktop, you have to include a laptop, you have to include smartphones, okay, you have to include tablets, all these devices, mobile phones, even all of these devices would be termed as some network components. Okay, so all these devices, okay, need to communicate with each other. So the collection of all these devices communicating with each other is called as a network. Okay, so that's where we have the different types of networks that can be created. A network that is created on the basis of mobile users, network that is created as headquarters or branch office in terms of buildings, and we can have a network in terms of home office. Okay, now I think today the participation in this particular training session or demo session is very low. Okay, so I would not continue much further ahead with this particular topic here, because you know, anyways, tomorrow I'm expecting more people to join in this particular demo session. So I might as well start off with this particular topic again, and I'll be continuing with this topic tomorrow. Okay, but as of now, since the participation is less, okay, we'll stop at this for today, and then I'll expect all of you to join in tomorrow, and then we'll continue with the remaining part of this particular topic. Okay, so see you guys tomorrow.